Jai Gurudev, good morning. Today we will start new concept. First of all, in the last class we have done up to your more concept. So starting from more concept, today we will start. The next one is your mole fraction. So we are starting with mole fraction designated by chi. Chi can be written like that. Mole fraction is the ratio of moles of a particular component. Mole fraction. Mole fraction is the ratio of moles of a particular component to total number of moles of all the components. So this part you have to write. This is your mole fraction. The fraction, as you know, it is, if you have, what is the fraction of boys in a class? If there is any boys and girls are there, what is the fraction? If there is 15 boys and 20 girls in a class, what is the fraction of boys in the class? There will be 15 divided by 15 plus 20. Means total 15 divided by 12. So this is how we have to go for the mole fraction. So if there is two types of component present in a mixture contains A and B, clear? Then how will you write the mole fraction? So if you want to write the mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A divided by number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. So again your chi B will be your number of moles of B divided by number of moles of A, number of moles of B. So what you are getting in this one, the mole fraction of A is equal to number of moles of A divided by number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. Mole fraction of B, number of moles of B divided by number of moles of A plus number of moles of B. Then here you remember mole means N is nothing but your given mass by molar mass. So if you want to find the number of moles of A, so that will be your given mass of A divided by molar mass of A. So like that, if you have written all these things, you will get the mole fraction of any component. So note down this one, then you will do one problem. So simple student, what you have learned about the mole fraction? Fraction means ratio. The mole fraction of a particular component is the total number of moles of, mole fraction of a particular component is the ratio of moles of that particular component. Means moles of that component divided by total number of moles. If there is two component system, we have written Na plus Nb. If there is three component system, we have to write Na plus Nb plus Nc. Like that. Now, if we add chi A and chi B, then what will happen? If If we add these two terms, Kaiye and Kaiwi, this plus this, Kaiye, Kaiwi, all of you may be done that one very easily. Na plus Nb plus Nb by Na plus Nb. This one is common. So in the numerator Na plus Nb, in the denominator also Na plus Nb. Now that turns to be 1. So here you have to conclude sum of the mole fraction of all the components is equal to 1. If a mixture contains number of components, plus plus IN is equal to 1. If the mixture contains several components, then also its mole fraction turns to be 1. So student, note down up to this, then we have to do some numerical problem based on your mole concept. So mole fraction. So now I'm taking one problem. The problem is an aqueous solution contains 20% potassium iodide. Contains 20% potassium iodide. Find the mole fraction of solute. In this particular question, student, we have to understood that solution is aqueous, means in solution solvent is your water. Now this part, 20% potassium iodide, what does it mean, 20% potassium iodide? So from this, what you understood from 20% potassium iodide, you straightforward you write down solute potassium iodide is equal to 20 gram. Then molar mass of potassium iodide, potassium is 39, iodine is 127. So these things will be there in the question paper, the potassium mass and iodine mass is there. So if you add them, you will get 166. Then mole fraction of potassium iodide is equal. Solute is 20 gram, the solvent is how much? Because a solution made of solute and solvent, out of that 20 gram is solute, so 80 gram will be your solvent. And molar mass of solvent, water, solvent is your water, so water that will be 18 gram. So what you have got in this one, first of all solute given your 20 gram, then you have molar mass of solute is 166 gram, then mass of solvent is 80 gram, and molar mass of the solvent is 18 gram. So if you have write the formula, you have to require to find chi of potassium iodide is number of moles of potassium iodide divided by number of moles of potassium iodide, number of moles of water, solute plus solvent. So that can be written as given mass by molar mass of potassium iodide. This is the moles of potassium iodide. Again, this one given mass by molar mass of potassium iodide plus given mass by molar mass of water. So, what is the given mass? Given mass of potassium iodide is 20 gram. 20 divided by molar mass is given 166. This one also 20 divided by 166. Now given mass for water. Water given mass is 18 and divided by 18. So you have to calculate out this one to get the result. So note down these things. From that you will get, for example, that whatever you get x, then if you want to wish to find out that for water, mole fraction of water, this is 1 minus x, that gives you the mole fraction of water also. So you have to calculate out all these things. So if you have got this value x, from this value of x you are able to get mole fraction of water, that is 1 minus x. So like that we are going to solve the problems regarding your mole fraction.